Hi everyone, welcome to part 2 of my campaign Haywire Outbreak. So here, at the end of the last mission, we reached actually the hardware store that we have right there. When reaching that, we found a bunch of resources that we are going to use to craft some items. So let's have a look at that. So here we have the list of resources. We have 2 alcohol, 2 rag, 2 canister, 1 scrap and 1 chemical. Let's have a look at what the recipe we know how to craft. So we basically have 3 recipes. The improvised shield, I don't have any binding. I don't have any tape or stuff like that, so I can't craft that. So we can park the improvised shield for now. I definitely need a bandage, that's super useful. So 1 coal, 1 rag, I'm going to craft 1 bandage. And I have enough to craft a Molotov cocktail, which is also super useful. So I'm going to use the second alcohol, the second rag, and 1 can. And 1 can to craft the Molotov cocktail. So I will pick the item after, but I know I crafted 1 of each. So let's pick those items. Okay, so that's the 2 new items I have. I still have the Molotov cocktail that I didn't use in the last mission. So now, talking about the next mission, what I'm going to do in terms of weapon and kits. So here, Terence will keep his fire axe, and I'm going to give to him the bandage again, just because in terms of roleplay, he's the firefighter, so makes sense for him to have the healing item. Here, Nick, he will keep the baseball bat. Plus a Molotov cocktail. I have Marcus here with the FN Scar H, and I'm going to give him also a Molotov cocktail. And on that side, I have Coach equipped with a shovel and the sniper rifle. So for now, I have 2 firing weapons, and I still found those 3 weapons in the previous games, so I'm wondering if I'm going to use some of them, because again, the number of firearms you have at the start of a mission define the threat level you start with. So if I start with only those 2 weapons, I will start at the threat level 2. And if I'm bringing like 4 weapons, I will start at the threat level 4, which will be harder, of course, more infected, more dangerous. So you know what, I'm going to do that. The pistol here is not super crazy, medium, can reroll within 6, but it needs to be up close. That AK sounds great on paper, but it uses the hard shooting stat, which is not perfect. This one could be great also, it uses the easy shooting stat, but the problem is that you only roll 1 dice. So it's not perfect. I still have 1 sniper here for Coach, but I'm going to stop there and I will hope to find some better weapon in that mission. So we'll start with 2 weapons. So I'm going to throw these away here and we will start then at the threat level 2. So I have my group of survivors here. Oops. Packing those cards. I have my group of survivors here that are already deployed, and that's the mission we are going to play on today. So again, the goal is to reach the opposite side. I've marked the extract with that dice just so we can see it well. Here we have the spawn point, so we have 1 here, 1 there, plus some others scattered around. And as always, I have weapon token next to every police or military vehicles, plus I have some resource token here and there, and I have 6 of them on the board. So that's pretty much it. We can get started on that next mission. So first action I'm going to do, there is a piece, there is that resource pod that I want to grab. So I'm going to move that guy 6 inches, will arrive roughly here, and then I'm going to use 2 sneak action to be able to reach that spot, and in the following turn I'm going to loot it. On that side over here, there is nothing else to loot in that small compound, so I will need to grab some of those resource spots here. But the first thing here is I will move 6 inches with Coach, And from there, here, if this guy move into that direction, that might be dangerous. But yeah, let's still do that. I'm going to move once. I'm going to do a sneak then. And I'm going to enter Overwatch. You know what? This guy have the sniper rifle, so I'm going to leave it a bit on the back. I'm going to put the two guy with melee weapons up front, so in case we trigger a group of infected, they will be able to attack them with the Overwatch shot. So the three of them are in Overwatch. So that's it for my turn. Let's jump into the infected turn. We start with this one over here. I'm going to grab two dice. Okay, so they are moving away. 2 inches in that direction. 2 inches will bring them over here. That's great. It will give me some time to loot that. I'm going to pause the camera to move all the other tokens. Okay, so I move all the other placement tokens, nothing too fancy, there is just that one that is looking in that direction, so if I'm moving in the open in front of the truck, he might be able to see me. No noise has been made, we jump onto the next turn. Next turn, I'm going first to loot that resource pot. And we found a one alcohol. Where are my yellow dice? I think they are here, yes. So one alcohol. We need some binding and some rag. I don't need the chemical yet. Didn't find any explosive stuff. We'll need them later, but for now, yeah, alcohol, rag, binding could be great. So I use my first action point to do that. I'm going to use my second action point to move on the back of the truck here. And yeah, maybe it's stuck with behind the rest of the team, so I'm just going to enter Overwatch with this guy. On this side, who would need a better weapon? Maybe Coach. So, 1, 2, 4. So yeah, the first movement will bring him roughly over here. Then I'm going to use a sneak action to reach this spot. And with the last action, I'm going to loot that weapon token. Oh, what is it? Memories from the past. When searching this area, this survivor find an object that made him think at the loved one he lost due to the virus. This survivor can only use the hard combat stat until the end of this game. Damn it. Ah, damn it. That sucks. That sucks, especially since Coach have that a sniper rifle that should be using the easy shooting stat, but now he's stuck with a 13 plus to kill any enemy. Damn it. And I didn't find any weapon, so... Ah, that sucks. I have 8 events in that deck with around 50 weapons, so yeah, really bad luck. Okay, so on this side, I'm going to do here, actually... Up to where this token can hear us. Okay, so he can hear up to basically that truck over here. So I'm not going to move. What I'm going to do? I could do 2 sneak just to reach here to be able to have line of sight on him. Yeah, let's actually do that. I'm going to do 2 sneak. I will arrive here, from there I can reveal that token. So let's grab a dice, I will move that a bit away, we are on the threat level 2, and we have only a single walker, so let's grab that walker here and place him there. Okay, so not too bad to start. I don't want to move again, I'm just going to enter Overwatch, so if this one turn, I will be able to kill him from there. Same thing with this guy, I'm going to do 2 sneak and going to enter Overwatch. So that's pretty much for this turn, we jump onto the infected. For the infected, I'm going to grab those 2 dice, so this one here, and actually he is turning, and he can see us, so now he's alerted and he move up to us. From there we trigger the Overwatch. First from Nick. So he rolled 2 dice. 2 dice, it used the medium combat stat, which is 11 plus. A 15 and a 4, this one is dead. Yeah, I'm going to pause now the camera. Maybe just I will move this one with you here since pretty closed. So this one doesn't move, it just turns into that direction. So now let's pause the camera and move all the others. I move all the tokens, we can jump on the next turn. Next turn, there is one resource there, plus one weapon I want to grab here. So, who could take the weapon? I will try to go with... you know what, I will use again Coach. He hasn't been very lucky this turn. So 6 inches will bring him over here, plus here another 3. So I'm doing one move of 6, one sneak of 3. And I'm going to loot a weapon, hoping that we don't have any more events. Ah, no way! 2 events in a row. I promised that deck was shuffled super well. I played already two campaign games. We shuffled that deck multiple times. Damn it! When trying to loot the location, the survivor drops an object making a loud noise. The closest threat token becomes alerted. Okay, so it's not too bad, but it's still bad. It's still bad because this one here becomes alerted and we can reveal it right away. I'm going just to park that with the rest of the weapons and we are going to roll to see what we have. Ooh, 17, it's a high number, I don't like... Oh, it's 4 walkers. 4 walkers, so let's place them on the board. Okay, so here I have those 4 walkers that just spawned. In the following phase, they will all move toward Coach. So, the first one is definitely within range, the other won't be within range. So I need at least to move one of my guys next to Coach and place him in Overwatch so he can try to beat that walker before he attacks us. So here, I am within line of sight on that threat token if I move in the open, but I don't have really a choice. With Nick here, I'm going to do 2 sneak actions. This way, it will be harder for the threat token to detect me. So 1 sneak of 3, a second sneak. I'm not going to move until the end of the 3 inch, just stopping him and putting him in Overwatch. When he moved there, this threat token might see him, but because he did a sneak, my surveyor did a sneak, he can only be detected on a 15 plus. And it's a 12, he hasn't been detected. On this side here, my firefighter. So if I do... My firefighter will do the same thing. He will first do a 3-inch movement, so a sneak, then a standard move up to here. And from there, he's going to loot this resource spot. It's a 4. A 4 means another scrap, which is great. Again, this guy did a sneak over here, so this threat token might saw him again on a 15 plus. It's an 11, he doesn't saw me, which is great. On this side, on the back here, I have Marcus. Marcus, what is going to do first? He's going to do a move. We have enough melee weapon to try to kill that whole pack of infected silently. But this will need to wait next turn. I'm not sure what I want to do. Just checking where we have some stuff to loot. We have 1 weapon here. We have 1 resource there. On the back here we have 1 weapon, 1 resource. Another weapon, another resource. And on this side we have 1 resource there. 1 weapon. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So my original idea was to come on the back here. And if I manage to kill that group silently, that's maybe what I'm going to do. But I still want to loot a bit some stuff. And here, it's pretty... not a lot of stuff to loot. Just 1 weapon. And I would like to find another one. yeah, we'll see. So this guy move 6 inches. I'm going to... You know what? He's going to... Ah no, I can't do another move because it will trigger this one. So here I'm going to do a sneak on the back of the truck up to here, and from there I'm going to do another move. So a sneak and another move up to here, and from there it's not in line of sight of the token there, so we are good. So that's the end for me. So now we jump onto the infected movement. So this one is definitely within range to reach my group of survivors. The closest one is Nick, so he will move towards Nick. Nick trigger is Overwatch. Again, two dice, medium, medium is even plus. Oh no, 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 no. 7 and 10, I missed my Overwatch shot. That means the infected arrive in base contact and it will try to attack me. The base walker here hit me on an 11 plus, so please, not an 11 plus. Ah no! Ah, you saw that, it was supposed to be a 8, but it banged on another dice. It's a 16. So I take 1 point of damage on Nick, which sucks. So next we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, basically the rest of the group is not within range. I'm just going to move them over here. So that's it for this group. I'm going to pause the camera and move all the other groups. Okay, so not great news. On this side here, this threat token move gain line of sight on my survivor, and just roll, so he becomes, well, we can already see him, so I can reveal that one. Oh no, 20, we have 4 walkers and 1 armored. Okay, so this group here just spawn, they become alerted, and they move also 6 inch towards my group of survivors. So we are just basically stacking next to the first group there. So I'm definitely going to need some of those Molotov cocktails. Okay, so that's the end of the infected phase. No noise has been made. Nothing spawn on the spawn point. We jump onto the next turn. So next turn, the first thing I want to do is get rid of this zombie, because here Nick is engaged in melee combat and thus far he can't move away. And since I want to throw a Molotov cocktail, yeah, I need to get rid of that one. One problem is that Nick has one of those cocktails, so he can't use that. What I'm going to do? Yeah, probably Nick will fight that one and move away, so here Marcus can throw his Molotov cocktail at the wall group. So let's do that. Nick here, I'm going to grab 2 dice for Nick. Medium, so I need 1 11 plus, and we have a 14 here, so I managed to successfully kill that one. And still have 1 action point, and with that action point I will move. The problem is, am I within? So yeah, I can't really move far into that direction because those threat tokens might see me actually. So right now I'm pretty safe, so I'm just going to move, yeah, roughly 4 inches in that direction. Yeah, just going to do that. Now I'm going to activate Marcus over here. Marcus is not going to move, he's going to throw his Molotov cocktail. A Molotov cocktail or a throwable can be thrown up to 12 inches, so I'm definitely within range. I'm aiming at this woman here with the red shirt. To throw, if you have line of sight, use the easy shooting stat. And that's the case here. So I have Marcus. I need a 9 plus to be able to land the Molotov cocktail exactly where I want. And perfect. We have a 12. The Molotov cocktail landed exactly where we needed it. So here I'm going to take out the Molotov cocktail and discard that. So the Molotov cocktail, just going to bring it up really quickly since it's the first time we are using it. The Molotov cocktail uses the throwable action. It inflicts 1 point of damage to all models within 1.5 inch of where it lands. So, it's basically a 3-inch radius, so I'm going to pick a 3-inch radius and place it over that lady. So here, basically, this one, I can remove them, so this one dead, 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 and dead. The armored infected here is hit, and he receives 1 point of damage, but he still have 2 points of damage. The armored infected have a total of 3 points of damage. So that's it for the Molotov cocktail. It's also, we still have some infected to fight. Oh, actually, yeah, that's, haha, that's a problem because. Let me check. So here I am within range with the fire hacks. Do I want to do that or not? The problem here is we still have coach that need a 13 plus to hit something. Damn it, damn it, damn it. I'm wondering if I should start firing or not. And that's a tough decision. With Marcus here, if I'm firing, this will alert this threat token here. But if I'm not firing, those three walkers will move, and here Nick is within range. I can move that guy here. I will try to be sneaky. So first step, Marcus here, he will do a 3-inch movement, he will do a sneak, and he will enter Overwatch. Just advancing slowly, not to be detected on this side. Here, Terence will do a standard movement up to here. From there, he will attack the armor infected. It's using the easy shooting stat. Yeah, so we need at least 1 9+. A 2 and a 6. Oh, that's not cool for me. So I use one action point to move, one action to attack. I still have one action point. So I'm using the last action point to attack, and here we have a 10. That fire axe is dealing 2 points of damage, so that's this icon. So here I successfully kill that armored infected. But we still have two infected to deal with. So let me bring the shovel here from coach. So the shovel, I'm hiding its name and the art, but I mostly need just it used two dice and it deal 1 point of damage. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to move coach over here, straight in the middle of those two guys. I'm going to attack first the one on the left. So here two dice and I need a 13 plus again because of the memories of the past event. Ah no, so close. 12 and 8, so one action point left. Please, please, please. And a 18, okay. 18 and 10. 18, I will kill this one here. So we still have one infected and we don't have any more action points. This guy here, Marcus, is in Overwatch. But yeah, not going to do anything. So that's the end of my turn. We jump onto the infected turn. The infected turn, this guy here will attack us. He hit me on a 11 plus. Is actually the closest one is Terence, and he did a 14, meaning Terence is also hit. He only have two action points left. Not cool. Now I'm going to roll the dice, at least for the three here that are pretty close. So this one here, he's moving 4 inches away, so 1 inch is touching the car and he's just moving to keep his 4-inch movement. Then that second one here is just turning in that direction, and the last one, okay, moving 1 inch away. I'm going to pause the camera to move all the others. So that's it. Nobody moved in a dangerous spot. We jump to the spawn phase. Here we use a cocktail Molotov. It's silent. It doesn't make any noise. So no new enemy jump on the board. We can jump onto the next turn. During the next turn, the first thing I'm going to do is to coach here will try to kill this zombie over here. So, coach or Terence? The thing here, if I'm using Terence, if I miss my shot, yeah, I want to use one of his action points to use the bandage to heal himself. So yeah, let's try coach. Again, I need 113 plus. So first action point, okay, 14, perfect. This infected is killed. So I still have two action points on coach. So I'm going to use 1, 2, move over here. I'm going to use the last one to move in base contact with that resource token so I can loot it in the following turn. On this side, Terence here will use one of his action points to heal himself, so we are throwing away the bandage. That's why resources are so important in that game, because as you can see here, we just already used two items, and those two items, to craft them, I needed 5 resources, so they are super important. One thing also, just so you know, there are some items, there are some weapons that have a flashlight. You can also craft a flashlight. And when you loot a resource pot with a flashlight, you don't grab one, but 2 resources. So that's also a super important item. If I can find a weapon with a flashlight, definitely going to keep it. So I use 1 action point to heal myself. So that means I have still 2 action points left now. So I'm going to where I want to go next. This one here is too far. I'm not going to try to go to this token. I have 1 here. I have 1 there. I would like to try to go towards the middle, but we'll see. Right now, this guy here, that's his line of sight. So you know what? Actually, I'm going to do that. 6 inches. He can't hear up to the sandbag, so I'm going to move here to gain line of sight on him. So let's roll to see what we have there. Ooh, 17. We have, okay, 4 walker. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we are 4 walker looking into that direction. So that might be interesting to throw another Molotov cocktail or not. They are so precious, I want to keep them for bigger threat with special infected. So we'll see. I still have 1 action point. With that last action point, I'm just going to move away. So in case they turn, they are not seeing me. On this side, we have that guy that is injured. So he can only use 2 action points. So here I'm going to just going to move next to Terence, and he's going to enter Overwatch. Marcus is going to do 1 move up to here. And from there, let me pause the camera so I can have a thought. Now, what I want to do next is to reveal this one just to know what we have here. So I'm going to move Marcus on this side. So I'm going to do a 3-inch movement, a sneak up to over here. And from there, I'm going to do another movement. So that will bring my guy right there. So next turn, I will be able to reveal this one. So that's it for me. We jump onto the infected turn. I'm going to pause the camera, move everything. Okay, so this group moved toward that resource token. This one moved away, so we are a bit safer on this side. So we jump onto the next turn. Here, Marcus is going to move to do a sneak action, move up to here to reveal this one. Here we have a 14. We have what? 2 walkers and 1 armored. So 2 walkers and 1 armored. So those guys are just looking at the side, so they don't see me yet. Which is great. And one thing. Weapon, gunshot can only be heard up to 18 inches. So let me grab just my 18-inch bar. So here, by the way, starting to work back on Haywire, the core rules, so expect more content on that once I'm done with this campaign. So here, if I'm firing, if I'm firing, this will alert the closest group within 18 inches. So basically, this group over here is within 18, so they can totally hear the shot. But if I'm moving a bit away, like over here, they won't be able to hear the shot, and I can fire at those guys here. So, you know what? I will try to do that. So I already used one action point. I'm going to move up to here. From there, no threat token, no enemy can hear that shot. This will still spawn new infected on the board and they will be alerted. But the one already present on the board won't be alerted. So I'm moving here and I'm firing at the first one here. And that will be my last action. So here, medium, I need an 11 plus and I have two dice. A 2 and a 12 is enough to hit, to kill that infected. So this group here is alerted and I'm fine with that. Now on this side, I have Coach over here. Coach will use his first action to loot that resource pot. So where I have a dice here, it's a 5, so another chemical. Too much chemical, not like that. With his second action point, he's going to move up to here to gain a line of sight on those two guys here. Just checking, I am still, it's a bit hard to see, but if I'm firing from there, so here, it's really on the edge, but I'm a bit behind, so that will be fine. I'm going to use not his shovel, of course. I'm going to use his sniper rifle. Normally, it should be great. He should be using the easy, but again, here he used the 13 because of the event. I have only one dice, so only one chance. So please try to be lucky. Yes, 13. And what is great? Why I wanted to do that is that the armored infected have a life strength of 3 and my sniper, my sniper rifle here have a strength, a power of 3. That means here I'm doing a one shot on that armored infected, which is perfect. So that's it on this side. No more action point there. By the way, sorry, that's just focusing on the kid, trying to make sure he's well sleeping. On this side, I'm not going to move toward that big group yet. I'm going to do a sneak because here, if I'm doing a standard move, they will hear me. So I will do two sneak action here with Terence up to here, and from there I'm entering Overwatch, and I'm going to do the same here with Nick. One sneak and one Overwatch. So if this group move in the mad direction, I can at least try to kill two of them. So that's it for me. We jump onto the infected phase. We start by moving the alerted infected. This one is alerted. She will move 6 inches toward the closest survivor. So here it's a bit, actually the closest survivor could be this one, but they are really close. So I'm just going to assume she moved towards the gunshot. So that's it. Now I will pause the camera for all the others, but I just want to check this one where it is moving. So it is looking in that direction and it is moving 4 inches. So it's a bit hard to define if those guys can see me, because here really they are moving, and here we have that bus here that is blocking their line of sight. So I'm just going to assume They didn't saw me. They were really moving, not really looking on the side. So let's say I'm safe for now. So that's it. I'm going to pause the camera, move the others. Okay, so I move all the other placement token. We can jump now onto the spawn phase. Since we did some gunshot, one new infected spawn on a random spawn point. One any group of infected. So what do we have? Okay, we have... So we have a 9. 9, it's not too crazy. It's one walker and one bloater. So let me grab one walker and one bloater. So it will be those two over here. They appear on the point number 6, which is right there. The thing is, let me... I don't have enough space. Even though I have a huge gaming space, it's never enough. When an alert group moves within 3 inches of an alert group, the alert spread. Sorry about that. So basically, this one is within 3 inches of this alerted group, so this one becomes alerted as well, and they will move towards me next turn. So I can reveal this one right away. Here we have a 16, which is two walkers and one bloater, so two walkers and one bloater, so it will be this. Two walkers and one bloater on this point. So those two groups are now alerted. Another problem is that since those two groups are now alerted, they will move toward me. There is chance they will moves within 3 inches of this one, so this one will become alerted. So I will need to hurry a bit to move out of the board, because yeah, there will be a lot of people coming into in my way. Anyway, that's the end of this turn. We jump onto the next turn. Actually, before jumping onto the next turn, since this turn we did some shot, we jump from turn 2 to turn 3, and now we can encounter some runners, which are pretty dangerous. So on this turn, what I want to do, so here I want to get rid of that one here, and I may try to do it silently. So let's try silently. So I'm going to move 6 inch with coach. I'm going to do another move up to here, and I will use my shovel again using the hard combat stat, so a 13 plus. Yes, I have a 16 over here, so this one is killed. Don't have any more action point on this one. With Marcus here, I'm going to do two moves that will bring me over here. With my last action point, I'm going to do another move up to here, so I can loot that point in the following turn. On this side, I'm going to... You know what? Yeah, I really should keep the Molotov cocktail for later. I don't want to lose it on that basic group. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to fall back. I can't unfortunately move, because if I move, they will hear me, so I need to do a sneak action. So Nick here will do two sneak actions that will bring him in the front of the bus, so in case they turn, they won't see him. And on this side, I'm going to do a sneak. Here I'm away from the 6 inch, so I'm going now to do a move that will bring me over here. And from there, I would like to move to be able, yeah, I will just move up to here with my last action point. So the next turn I can move, loot, and come back here. I will just hope for this group to not come into my direction. So that's it for this turn. That's it for this turn. We jump onto the infected. So we start again with the alerted infected. So this one is moving 6 inches in my direction. So while doing so, the alert spread to that new group, so we can reveal that group. And we have an 11. An 11, okay, not too bad. It's only three basic walkers. Grabbing the walkers underneath my table. So when this group becomes alerted, he also, oh no. Oh, do we have a chain reaction or not? It move three, it moves 6 inches towards me, which brings him over here. And are those guys, okay, so now it's really on the edge. Yeah, 4 inch, but no, it's 3 inch to spread the alert, so they are not alerted. And we have this group over here that also move 6 inch towards me, like that. So all those guys are alerted, so yeah, try to move away from the board before they arrive on me. Next, I'm going to move this group of 4. Okay, so they move 2 inch against the wall there, which is great. They turn a bit into that direction, but I move my team away so they don't see them. And the last two threat token, there is one over here. He's just turning, and there is one that is hiding next to the extract, and he's also not moving actually. So that's it, no gunshot, nothing spawn, we jump onto the next turn. Next turn, you know what, next turn it's coach that will be looting, so I'm going to use one action point to move here, I'm going to loot that weapon spot with coach. Yes! Oh, cool! We have an MPX, so a submachine gun, which is great, because you first you roll 3 dice, so that's lots of chances. It uses the medium, but that's still okay since you use 3 dice, but the main thing is that it has a flashlight. It has a flashlight. So I'm going to... I can equip 2 weapons only if one of them is a melee or pistol. So basically, I can have the shovel and the MPX, or I can have the shovel and the sniper, but I can't have the MPX and the sniper. So I'm going to put in my inventory the sniper, and I'm going to keep the shovel and the MPX. Even though, yeah, I don't think I will be able to grab any more resources. Yeah, the next one is over here, but I will be too far. So that will be for the next turn. Next, like I mentioned here, Terence will do a standard move that will bring him over here, that will raise the alert of this group since I'm doing a standard move and not a sneak. But I will loot that resource spot. Please, a 2. I need a 2. And it's a 1. Huh. Next, so I looted that. Next, I'm going to do a. So here we have that other guy here. I don't want to trigger him, and they will only move 6 inches. So if I'm doing a sneak, a 3-inch move on the right here, I should still be safe. So I'm going to move him here, because here there are 1, 2, and 3. Token, I would really like to grab them. We'll see. On this side, Marcus. Marcus will just move on top of the car. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That will bring him over here. Another movement. If I'm doing a second movement, this guy will hear me, so I will do a sneak, and I'm going to enter Overwatch. And on this side, I'm going to move Nick. Yeah, I will do, actually. Yeah, I will do 2 movements with Nick here. There is a spawn point, but since we didn't make any noise, nothing will spawn here. So yeah, that's pretty much it for me. We jump onto the enemy. Alerted infected start first, so we jump. So these guys will move over here. This second group here will move up to there, so they are just stacking up, making a big crowd, and basically all the others will also just follow along. Here it would be great to land some shot just to have some nice explosion, but yeah, that's not going to be this turn. Now we jump onto the threat token. Where are my dice here? So on this side, this threat token. No, it will be fine. I'm still far enough to not trigger this one. So 1, 2, 3, it will bring him over here. So from actually. It's a bit hard to say. Yeah, I'm going to assume I don't see him. And the other one, 1, 2, 3, is moving away, which is great for me. Which is great. So 1, 2, 3 is moving in that direction. I'm really pushing my luck with Terence because he's really on its own there. We'll see what happens. What I can try to do is that the walkers, well, all infected, only move toward the closest infected. So if I move Terence far enough from this horde and bring, for example, Coach a bit closer, they won't move in that direction, they will move towards Coach. So that's a way to distract and to give a bit of air, of fresh air for Terence. But yeah, we'll see next turn what happens. End of this turn, nothing spawn, we jump onto the next turn. Next turn, the first thing I'm doing here is where can Nick move? Yeah, he won't be in range, Nick. So I'm going to do a move with Marcus facing that infected here, facing that threat token. But what do we have? We have, oh, three, it's not too bad. Yes, we have a single runner. A single runner, grabbing the runner under my table. So this is great. Ah, this is great, yes and no. Because if I am firing right now, the threat token that is on the back over here, this one, will become alerted since he is within 18. And he will move toward the closest survivor and it will be Terence. Which is not what I want. So what should I do here? You know what? I'm going to move around this threat token with Marcus, this infected. So I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That will bring Marcus. So I'm just going to just move away from him, avoiding that infected to so he can't catch me. On this side, I'm going to move Nick really close. He won't be able to reach it to attack this turn, but I'm going to place him in Overwatch. And since I will be the closest to this infected, he will attack me. I'm doing this on this side. So the threat token, if he becomes alerted, I can maybe land some shots. So here that Marcus is placed in Overwatch. On that side, I have two weapons and a resource, but what I really need first is the resources. So I'm going to do a standard move to grab that. Where can this group go? Yeah, so first really is the move. Yeah, let me have some fort actually. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is to loot that resource spot. So here we are. Ooh, yes, we have a 2. We have a 2. This is exactly what I was missing to craft a new bandage. Not 1, not 2, 1 resource. So that's great. Now, what next? What next with this guy? I moved, I looted. I'm trying to see if I want to move to this token or this token, because that other one is really far. So, well, no, yeah, I will try to move that. We'll see what happens. I'm still out of range, so yeah, let's do that. And let's have some thought on the rest. Okay, so finally, the last guy is Coach here. Unfortunately, there is not that much he can do. Yeah, if he's trying to lay down some shot, that will just make potentially a new threat token appear here or over there, so I don't want that. So he's just going to move on top of the car, so 2, 3, 4. So one movement, then a second movement. Ah, actually, yeah, I will do that. He will just move here, so in case Nick is missing his Overwatch shot, he will try to do one. So that's it for my turn. We jump onto the infected. That guy here arrive in base contact with me. I'm going to do a combat action, so I need an 11 plus and a 20. Perfect. So I kill that runner. It's a shame because I really wanted a runner to spawn far and to show you how far they can move. Next, we have this group of alerted infected. So this group here is going to move 6 inch toward Terrence. It will bring them over here. That other group on the back, yeah, I'm just going to move there in this direction. Wasn't sure if it was shorter path from the other side of the truck. But yeah, let's say it's closer that way. So that's it for the infected. And now for the token on the back here, I'm just going to roll those two dice. Okay, so, oh, actually, he moved 5 inches towards the alley. So basically, 5 inches, it will bring him here, just in front of Marcus here. So let's roll a die to see what we have there. We have an 11. An 11, we have 3 walkers. 1, 2, 3. They immediately become alerted. They immediately become alerted. So I can right away place them. And they can again be activated and start moving toward Marcus. Thankfully, as you can see over here, yeah, just basically the first one may reach Marcus, but I can fire in Overwatch. So that's what I'm going to do first. So I will fire in Overwatch 2 shots again on 11 plus. So we have an 18 here, an 18, I mean, I kill that first infected. The bad news is that I'm making noise. And the two other infected will move. Yeah, I'm just going to move that away. And the two other infected arrive in the back alley just in front of me. So that's it for the infected, but we did a gunshot. That means a new group of infected will spawn on the board. So let's pray it's not 2 or 4. We don't need a 2 or a 4, or a 3, of course, 3. So here, sorry, I wasn't focusing. So we have a 4 on a 3. A 4 means 2 walkers. So 2 walkers appear at the BKLA taxi entry. It's not too bad, but it's not the perfect spot. So that's it for the infected and the spawn phase. Just going to put that back in place just because it looked nicer. So yeah, we can jump finally on to the next turn. There is a lot of walker here. I really need to think at what I want to do with Terrence, and yeah. Okay, so since I'm really close to the extract, first thing I'm going to do here is move Coach over here, so he's in range to fire at the two walker. Again, you have the sniper rifle And the event, I can only hit on a 13 plus. So targeting the first one. Miss, targeting the second one. And we have a 20 on the second one. So we have killed one of them. So we'll kill this one. With Nick. Nick is within range to move up to this one. So he will move up to this one here. I'm going to try to leave the dice next to him. With Nick, I can I have the baseball bat, so I can hit on an 11 plus. Yeah. Trying to roll dice on that now because I don't want to wake everybody at home. I'm sorry, banging all the scenery. Of merde, boss, damn it. I needed at least one 11 plus. So, Nick miss his combat action. So, yeah, and now he's just in front of us, so I can't fire with Marcus. So Marcus is going to move around. Yeah, I'm going to move around with Marcus. Just, where can I move? I wanted to come over here with Marcus to try to grab some loot, but I don't think I will be able to do that. So basically here with Marcus, I'm just going to come over here and fire at that walker. So I need an 11 plus, 8 and 19. Okay, this one is dead. I still have one action point with Marcus, and I'm just going to move 6 inches towards the end of the back alley over here. But I'm not sure I will be able to do anything to help Terence. So now let's have some thoughts on what I want to do with Terence. Yeah, so what I'm going to do is that I'm going to loot that weapon spot first. Okay, so we have a medium weapon. It's not perfect, but it has a flashlight. So I'm definitely going to equip that in addition to the fire axe. And now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to do two move action. I'm going to stay away from the crowd here, moving just next to the headlight of this car. I'm going to do a first move, we'll bring him over here. It's really a shame for this weapon spot. We'll see what happen in the next turn. So, but yeah, I might try. I'm not sure. No, there are too many of them to try to grab the loot, I think. So yeah, that's the end of my movement. Now, that's the end of my phase. We jump onto the infected phase. I'm going to pause the camera and move everybody closer to me. So end of the infected movement. This group move in that direction. All the others move towards the back alley here. At the end of last turn, we did some gunshots, so we increased the threat level. We are now at the threat level 2. And this turn, we again made some gunshots, meaning a new group will arrive. So we have 8 on the point number 5. We have one walker, one bloater. One walker, one bloater arriving at the point number 5 over here. And again, this turn, since we did some gunshots, we switch from level 4 to level 5. So now the good question. Do I want I'm going to leave those two resources and I'm not going to do anything. I'm just going to rush towards the extracts. One move plus another move, and with those two guys, I'm going to do two move action to reach the extract. So yeah, that's the end of this mission. We have one injured survivor and unfortunate. No, we have enough resource to craft a bandage. And yeah, we'll see what we craft in the start of the following turn, same for the loot where what we are going to keep and whatnot. We didn't find any weapon, right? Except oh no, we find the SMG here, plus the pistol. No, so that's still a pretty good run. At the end of this mission, we reach the crash site. I forget to say where I was heading, but I was heading for the crash site because I wanted one new survivor to join my group. So let me pause the camera to grab the survivor's deck. Okay, so I have my survivor's deck. The original idea was to randomly pick a survivor, but just in terms of roleplay, I find it cool that at the garage I can find the mechanic. So here, basically, I'm going to handpick and select the new survivor that joined my group. Here, it uses the same stat as all the other survivors. It's a civilian, so I'm definitely not just picking like one police or one special forces. It's definitely not the best stat. It's the most common stat. It starts with a wrench, so again, not super strong weapon to start with, but it was just mostly because for the roleplay, I find it cool to start with him, and that's the model I'm going to use. Super cool sculpt from Vault Z miniature, and he will go very well with Coach and Nick, because if you are not familiar, that's actually the cast, the crew from Left 4 Dead 2, and actually that was really not intended. It was not planned to have that. I'm just missing one character for the crew, but yeah, I probably won't encounter her in that campaign. So that's it for this mission. Hope you like it, and I will see you all for the next one. Bye, everyone.